As I stand here inside the cells exhibit, anyone, anytime, anywhere, understanding the threat of terrorism, I'm reminded of the morning of September 11th, 2001. I remember turning on the television and saying, how can this possibly be happening in the United States of America? Well, it's something that we're going to have to deal with the rest of our lives. The horrific events of September 11th and the Oklahoma City bombing have made it clear that terrorism is not only a very real threat abroad, but also right here at home. Anyone can become a victim of terrorism, anytime, anywhere. Together, we can change this. Each of us has a responsibility to protect our community, and we can do so by recognizing the signs of terrorism and taking proper action to stop it.
Experts agree that there are 8 signs of terrorism we should watch out for. Surveillance, elicitation, tests of security, funding, acquiring supplies, impersonation, rehearsal, and deployment.
When you witness any suspicious activities, you should report them to the Colorado Information Analysis Center, the CIAC, and for imminent threats, call 911.
Surveillance. While planning, terrorists often survey a potential target to determine its strengths and weaknesses. This may include determining how well a target is protected, identifying what type of security measures are in place, and gauging emergency response times by local police and rescue units. How do you distinguish between a tourist taking souvenir photos and a terrorist surveying a target? Often, it's about what they are taking a picture of. Are they looking at the scenery or a high security facility? Suspicious surveillance activity may include someone recording or monitoring activities, drawing diagrams, making notes, using vision-enhancing devices, acquiring floor plans or blueprints, or showing interest in the security and access points to facilities. Any of these surveillance methods may be a sign that something isn't right, and you should report it to the CIAC. Elicitation. Another sign of terrorism is elicitation. This is where terrorists attempt to gain information from people or organizations related to their target. Terrorists often inquire about operations and security of important places, such as a power plant, school, stadium, or shopping mall. Elicitation attempts are made by mail, email, telephone, or in person. Some terrorists even gain employment to monitor day-to-day activities to gather detailed information about their target. Call the CIAC if you observe any such activity.
Testing security is another key step in terrorist planning. Have you ever been on a bus or a light rail and noticed a bag that has been left unattended? This could be an example of a terrorist determining how long it takes for people or security to respond. Terrorists also frequently trespass into restricted areas to test security. It is vital that if you witness someone engaging in these activities, you should report it immediately and call 911.
Funding. It's expensive to run a terrorist operation. Terrorists not only need to raise money, but they also need to transfer and spend it in a way that doesn't bring attention to themselves. Typical crimes for funding can be anything from drug and people trafficking to burglary and sales of illegal merchandise. They have also been known to funnel money from charitable organizations and legitimate business operations. There are many signs to watch out for, such as witnessing an unusually large transaction that's paid for with cash or gift cards, and also being vigilant of donations toward a charity you've never heard of. If you see something that may be suspicious, call the CIAC immediately.
Acquiring supplies. To conduct an attack, terrorists need a variety of supplies, which include weapons, transportation, and a communication system. You might observe a suspicious-looking vehicle in a strange area, or come across to someone buying a number of one-time-use cell phones. You may even notice a garage filled with stockpiles of fertilizer, odd machinery, or even weapons. Terrorists also use aliases to avoid suspicion and obtain access to their targets. Forging personal identification or passports and stealing or acquiring uniforms are all suspicious activities and should be reported immediately.
Suspicious persons or impersonation. When someone's behavior seems suspicious because of what they say or do, this could be a red flag. Terrorists will impersonate law enforcement, mail carriers, or company employees to gain information. If you see something that may be abnormal or have a gut feeling that something is just not right, call the CIAC.
Rehearsal phase. Terrorists will often rehearse a pending attack, sometimes several times, to ensure their operation will run smoothly. The run-through may include putting their operatives in position, monitoring police radios, and measuring emergency response times by area police and firefighters. If you witness any activity in which danger seems imminent, call 911 immediately.
Deployment. During the deployment phase, terrorists are arranging their assets, getting into position, or are in the midst of an attack. If you witness someone engaging in these activities, you should report it immediately and call 911. It's important for all of us to realize when a terrorist incident occurs, it affects everyone. You can make a difference in helping stop an attack by being able to recognize the 8 signs of terrorism and alert the authorities. If you or a family member sees any sort of suspicious activity, you shouldn't attempt to stop a suspect. Rather, report it immediately by calling 911 or the CIAC.
The success of securing our community's safety depends upon our shared commitment. It's a beautiful day here in Colorado, and there can be many more days like this with the help of people like you.